Welcome to this session on external authentication providers. In this session, we'll see how OutSystems authenticates IT users and how we can change the authentication provider. There are a number of steps that will help us do that, from mapping users from the external system to changing the authentication plugin and then configuring that authentication plugin. And then we'll need to test and propagate the configuration to all of the different environments. And finally, we'll talk about customizing your own authentication plugin. So let's go ahead and get started. So how does OutSystems authenticate IT users? When an IT user tries to access the infrastructure, OutSystems checks the authentication method that is configured. If it's using the default built-in authentication, OutSystems will validate things locally and then create the credentials needed for the user. If an external authentication provider is configured, OutSystems delegates this to the external authentication plugin. The plugin is responsible for validating the credentials externally and then returns a unique user ID, which will be mapped to an OutSystems user ID. So how would we change the authentication provider? To do this, we would first need to map the users from the external system into OutSystems, so an OutSystems user exists for them. Then we'd need to choose the new authentication method. We could then configure that authentication provider in the lifetime environment and then begin testing the configuration settings. If the configuration settings work, then we'd want to propagate those settings to all of the other environments. Once they're in all of the other environments, we should test in each of the different environments and then finally apply the changes. So let's look at some more details and see this in a step-by-step fashion. So to start with, mapping users from the external system means that we need the IT users that need access to lifetime to have a corresponding user in lifetime. So mapping users from an external authentication provider can be performed manually or automatically. The users can just be created manually in lifetime, or we can attempt to automate this process by using the Lifetime Services API. For more information about that API, check out the success documentation below. We can also go in and change the authentication plugin. Out of the box, OutSystems provides an Active Directory and an LDAP authentication provider. So to choose one of these, we just have to select them from the list and begin to configure that authentication provider. And here you can see we need to select that we're using an external authentication provider for this to actually become active. By default, we have the OutSystems built-in authentication selected. So, to configure the authentication plugin is relatively simple. For each of the different types, like the Active Directory authentication, there's some information that needs to be provided, and then we can click Save Configuration. Once we set the configuration, we would then want to test it by seeing if a user can log in with that particular configuration. So here we can see we would have asked for an external authentication provider, selected the Active Directory choice. At this point, we would have configured it and we should have tested it. So once we had tested it and the user could log in, the next step would be to propagate this to all the different environments. So here you can actually see a summary of the steps and what's happened so far. So we started configuring the external authentication. We then tested the plugin in the lifetime environment, and it returned that that test succeeded. We would now propagate this from the lifetime environment to the other environments like development, quality, and production. So to propagate the configuration, once testing is done, we ask the propagation to occur, and then we'll need to go to those environments and test if it actually works before we want to apply it in those different environments. So here you can see we can propagate it to all of the different environments, and it will show us that yes, this has been propagated to development, and this has propagated to production. And in this particular infrastructure, those are the only two environments that we have. So these are all the different steps that it takes, and at this point we can apply the configuration and everything will be okay. So that helps us with choosing and setting up one of the existing authentication providers. In the OutSystems Forge, there are other authentication provider plugins available, which have been created by members of our community. Since these authentication plugins are related to security and could compromise your security, we recommend that you test and validate all of them before using them. There's also reference documentation so you can learn how to implement your own custom authentication provider plugin. So this would allow you to specifically meet whatever needs you might have. And again, in the success area, there is documentation on how to implement an authentication plugin. So that's it for the external authentication providers session. Thanks for watching and have a great day.